Hello students, welcome to the video lecture session on industrial drives and application. Today I am discussing the module 2. Let us have a glance over syllabus consists. The syllabus is selection of motor power ratings. Under this, thermal model of motor for heating and cooling, classes of motor duty, determination of motor ratings. Next bit is direct current motor drives, DC motor drives it is. In this bit, single phase fully controlled rectifier and single phase half controlled rectifier. Okay, control of DC separately excited motor we are going to study here. Next bit is three-phase fully controlled rectifier. Here also, in this bit, control of DC separately excited motor, three-phase half controlled rectifier, control of DC separately excited motor. Next bit is multi-quadrant operation of DC separately excited motor fed from fully controlled rectifier, rectifier control of DC series motor, supply harmonics, power factor and ripple in motor current. Last bit is chopper control of separately excited DC motor, chopper control of series motor. Okay, this is the syllabus. Let us begin with, first what I will do, I will cover this bit, multi-quadrant operation of DC separately excited motor fed from fully controlled rectifier. Okay, this bit I am controlling. After this, I will go for chopper control of separately excited DC motor. Okay, first two video I will make under this. Okay, let us begin with the first bit, multi quadrant operation of DC separately excited motor fed from fully controlled rectifier. So here the multi-quadrant operation means the operation with regenerative braking is considered. Okay, in this drives the all four quadrant operation I am going to discuss here. So here the possible three methods are discussed. First one is single fully controlled rectifier with a reverse switch. Second one is using dual converter. Third one is single fully controlled rectifier in the armature with field current reversal. Okay, so the first one, before starting the first one, let us worry on the fully controlled rectifier. Single phase fully controlled converter, it will be operates, already I have discussed about this. Okay, just I will review on the controlled rectifier. So here the controlled rectifier operates in the two quadrant, one is say first quadrant and fourth quadrant, and also I have discussed about the firing angle, it will be lies between 0 to 90 degree in first quadrant and in between 90 to 180 under fourth quadrant. Okay, so also we know that the first quadrant it is motoring operation and fourth quadrant it is reverse regeneration, regenerative operation. Okay, so now this is the quadrant operations. Okay, first quadrant rectification or motoring operation, second quadrant inversion, reverse regeneration, third quadrant reverse motoring, and second quadrant is forward regeneration. Okay, so here the single fully controlled rectifier with a reversing switch. Okay, the first one is the fully controlled rectifier, which it will be operates under two quadrant. So other two quadrant here you are obtaining by reversing the supply by using the switch. Here the there are the figure A is simplified circuit, it is shown. R and S are reversing switches. Okay, forward and back means the supply voltage can be reversed. So the second circuit B, it shows the FF contactor. We can say here the contactor we can use to change the supply voltage to armature. So FF, if you are turned on, the positive voltage is applied. Say it is armature point A, and AA means it will be positive and negative it will be comes. And when we are turning on the contactor R and FF, it will be turns off or opened, then the supply voltage will be reversed. So these things can be obtained with help of the switching device SCR, silicon controlled rectifier. With help of this four SCR, we can operate in the forward direction and reverse direction. Okay, if the switch TF turned on, the supply will be connected to the motor in one direction, and the TR switch is turned on and TF switch are turned off, the supply will be reversed, it will be connected to the armature. So here the forward direction and the reverse direction we can obtain. So in this before going to the next slide, let us little worry on this. Okay, so here what it is there, if the TF it is turned on, first and fourth quadrant we will get, and if the switch TR and TR are turned on, TF and TF are turned off, then the third and second quadrant we will get. So hence here we will get all four quadrants. So now the discussion about the speed reversal, how the speed will be reversal will be done. There are following steps need to follow. Okay, transfer from, see, speed reversal is nothing but the transfer from the quadrant first to the third, or we can say that third to the one. Okay, so here how it will be done means the firing angle of the rectifier is set at the highest value, then it works as an inverter. After the zero current sense, the firing pulses are stopped. Okay, so for an example, assume here TF it will be one direction motor is running, and thyristor TF are turned on. Now what we are done here, the TF firing angle will be kept in highest value. Okay, so it takes a highest value, just I will go to that. Okay, highest value, so that it works as an inverter and reduces armature current to zero. After the zero current sensed, firing pulses are stopped. Now the delay time we will allow here 2 to 10 millisecond is provided to make this sure that the thyristor which we are conducting have fully turned off. Okay, the time 2 to 10 millisecond is the more enough, as the thyristor it will require very few hundred microseconds. Okay, so here once the it will be turned off completely. Now the next step is the armature connection is reversed and firing pulses are released with the firing angle set at the highest value. So other pair of SCRs, firing angles will be released with highest value, and motor it will be drives in the reverse direction. Okay, so first quadrant to the, we are moved to the third quadrant. Okay, that time what it will be happens, the voltage will be reversed and current also reverses. Okay, so if you are looking to the third quadrant, you can see there the voltage and current both are in negative. So hence it is called reverse motoring operation in third quadrant. Okay, so let us begin with the second discussion, dual converter. Okay, so dual converter means the name itself indicate that there are two converters. One is converter called the name A converter and B converter. Okay, so these two converters are connected in anti-parallel across the armature. I repeat here, the two fully controlled rectifiers connected in anti-parallel across the armature. So what it will be happens here, the rectifier A, which provides positive motor current and voltage in either direction, allows motor control in quadrant 1 and 4th, whereas rectifier B provides motor control in quadrant 3rd and 2nd because it gives negative motor current and voltage in either direction. Okay, so here Already I have discussed these points. Okay, so hence the dual converter can be provide four quadrants, because one converter will be operates first and fourth quadrant, and the second converter will be operates under quadrant third and second. Hence it gives a four quadrant operation. Okay, let us know the operation of dual converter briefly. I will explain here. There are two methods, we can say the two methods are involved here, the modes of operation of dual converter. One is called a non circulating current mode, also it will be say also we used to say that non simultaneous current control method. Okay, so second one is circulating mode or simultaneous current control method. Okay, the first one is non circulating current mode. Circulating current means the if you are looking to the here, there will be a inductance. Okay, inductance are provided L1 and L2. Why means? Because there will be a small current will be flows, that is called circulating current. Why means? Because the both the converters turned on, then there will be a VA or instantaneous voltage, we can say the VA and VB are equal, but it will be in the different in the phases, hence we will get some current. Okay, that current is called a circulating current. Okay, so let us first begin with the non-circulating current mode. Non-circulating current mode, what it will be happens in non-circulating current, there will be a no circulating current will be flows. Okay, so how the converters are operated here? One converter will performs at a time. It means what? The one converter, say it is converter A, it will be operates at a time. And if I want to operate in the converter B, that time converter A, it will be in off. Okay, during the converter 1 operation, firing angle alpha 1 will be in between, lies between 0 to 90 degree. VDC and IDC are positive. I repeat here, the voltage and current are in positive if the converter 1 is operated. Okay, during the converter 2 operation, firing angle alpha 2 will be operated, and here also the firing angle will be lies between 0 to 90 degree. VDC and IDC are negative. Why it is VDC and IDC are negative in the converter 2? Because it is connected, if you are looking to the here, the rectifiers connected in anti-parallel. If you are looking closely to this, the anti-parallel, it is connected. B converter is connected in anti-parallel to the EA. Okay, so here the non-circulating current operation is over. It means what? At a time one converter is operated, say it is converter A is operated and converter B it is in off, and when you are operating the converter B, converter A it will be off. So one converter will perform at a time, and the firing angle of the switches are in between 0 to 90 degree. So here what it will be happens, I conclude here, the one converter 0 to 90 degree means it will be gives the positive VDC and IDC, means first quadrant and fourth quadrant I will get. During the converter 2 operation, firing angle will be lies in the 0 to 90 degree only, but VDC and IDC are in a negative, hence third quadrant and second quadrant we will get. Hence the fourth quadrant operation will be, we can obtain from this dual converter. Okay. So circulating current mode. Okay, so here the two converter will be in the on condition at the same times, so circulating current is present. The firing angles are adjusted such a that the firing angle of converter 1 alpha 1 plus firing angle of converter 2 alpha 2 is equal to 180 degree. This is the very important one point. Okay, so the alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to 180 degree. We are adjusting in a such a manner. Converter 1 performs as a controlled rectifier when firing angle is 0 to alpha 1 90 degree. In between lies between 0 to 90 degree, converter 1 it will be performs. And converter 2 performs as an inverter when the firing angles will be in between 90 to 180 degree. Okay, so in this case what it will be happens, VDC and IDC are positive. Converter 1 performs as an inverter with firing angle 90 degree to 180 degree. Now the case is reversed. First case is what? The converter A, it will be operated as any 0 to 90 degree, and converter B, it will be operated in between 90 to the 180 degree. Now the case, it will be reversed. Converter 1 of operated between 90 to 180 degree, and converter 2 operates between 0 to 90 degree. So now in this case, the VDC and IDC are negative. Okay. So the last bit of discussion is how the speed reversal will be carried out in the both the cases. One for non-circulating current mode. Okay. Non-circulating current mode, there is no circulating current will be flows, and the inverter, rectifier, control rectifiers are used at a time, one at a time. Okay. So now the circulating current mode, how the speed reversal will be done, briefly I will discuss here. Okay. When operating in quadrant 1, rectifier A will be supplying the motor and rectifier B will not be operating. As I mentioned earlier also, at a time one converter it will be operated. Now what it will be happens, A it will be operating and B it will be not operating, right? So the firing angle of A will be, you are keeping setting to the value will be very high, so the more than 90 degree will give. Then the rectifier works as an inverter and forces the armature current to zero. This is a very important, what it is, the first converter A, you are setting to the value of more than 90 degree, and what it will be, it acts as an inverter. So hence it will be forces to armature current to zero. After providing the, ensure the turn off of the thyristor of rectifier A. Now the firing pulses are withdrawn. So what we are doing, after the turn off of the thyristors, the firing pulse will be removed and the pulse is withdrawn from the rectifier A, transferred to the rectifier B. Now what it will be happen, the firing angle alpha B, means the converter B will be set initial zero current sensed. Then after 2 to 10 millisecond is provided, ensure that all the thyristors should be turned off in the rectifier A. Now firing pulses are withdrawn from the rectifier A and transferred to the rectifier B. Okay, so now the firing angle alpha B is set initially at highest value. So what it will be happens, if you are providing very high firing angle, means the highest value you are keeping near to the 70 degree or 175 degree. So what it will be happens, the output voltage will get less. As we know that if the firing angle will be more, the output voltage will be less. Okay, so that it will be drives to the motor in slowly to the in reverse direction. Okay, so this is the explanation related to the non-circulating current mode. Now I will discuss about the circulating current mode how the speed reversal is done. Okay, so here what it is, there the when operating in the quadrant first, rectifier A will be rectifying. Okay, it is its firing angle is lies between 0 to 90 degree, and rectifier B will be inverting, that is lies between 90 to 180 degree, in between 90 to 180 degree. For speed reversal, alpha A is increased and alpha B is decreased. Okay, alpha A, earlier it was less than 90 degree, now we are increasing that one. And 180 degree, what it is there, that it will be decreasing. Satisfy the equation. Okay, what is the meaning here? The satisfy means alpha A plus alpha B is equal to 180 degree. We should keep in this equation satisfy. Then only we will move. Then only it is possible to change the speed. Then only we can change the speed reversal. Okay. The motor back EMF exceeds magnitudes of VA and VP. The armature current shifts to the rectifier B to the operates in the quadrant 2. The current control loop adjusts this firing angle alpha B continuously, so it has to brake the motor at the maximum allowable current. So what it will be happens, it will be initially speed to the 0, then drive motor speed, it will be goes to the 0 speed, and then it will be accelerate. It will be accelerate in the reverse direction, or we can say that the desired speed in the reverse direction. Okay, as alpha B is changed, alpha A is also changed to satisfy the equation. Okay, so alpha A plus alpha B, 180 degree. So now here the first quadrant to the third quadrant we are shifting, or we can say the third quadrant to the first quadrant, the reverse motoring we can do with help of these steps. Okay. So this is the converter, dual converters, four quadrant operations. Okay, so first quadrant alpha 1 is less than 90 degree, it will be rectifying mode. Okay, so if the converter 2, it will be greater than 90 degree, second quadrant. Okay, so alpha 2 less than 90 degree, third quadrant, and similarly alpha 1 is greater than 90 degree, converter 1 it is in fourth quadrant. So okay, so here what it is there, if you are looking to this one, the first quadrant and fourth quadrant converter 1 it will be operates. I repeat here, the conclusion point is the first quadrant and fourth quadrant, so the forward motoring and regenerative braking, the converter 1 it will be operates, and converter 2 when it will be on, converter 2 it will be operates under the quadrant third, that is reverse motoring, and second quadrant regenerative braking. Regenerative braking. Hence, the all four quadrant operation can be obtained using the dual converter. I conclude here, the using the dual converter, all four quadrant operation can be obtained. These are the equation, average output voltage of three phase converter and single phase converter. Okay, this equation is one is very important here to solve the numeric question. Okay, three phase converter, that output voltage is equal to 3 Vm cos alpha divided by pi. This equation you have to remember it, because one numeric problem I will solve in the next session. Okay, so last one more bit is there and I will conclude. Okay, last one is C. Okay, first one is as I discussed, a single fully controlled rectifier with reversing switch. Second one is dual converter. Third one is single fully controlled rectifier in armature with field current reversal. So here if you are looking to this circuit, the armature is fed to the directly to through the converter, whereas in field there are two converters are used. Okay, so we can change the direction of the supply to field with help of this converter. Okay, so here the brief discussion about how the speed reversal will be done. Okay, the armature rectifier fairing angle is set to the highest value. Okay, so the which converter? Armature circuit. There we are setting the highest value, force the armature current to zero, and then firing angle or firing pulses are withdrawn. The firing angle of the rectifier supplying the field now set the highest value. It operates as an inverter and field current is forced to zero. After a suitable dead time, the second rectifier is activated. So here what it will be happens, the second rectifier is activated means it will be goes to the reverse, the supply it will be reversed. When the field current has nearly settled and the motor back EMF has reversed, okay, the firing pulses of the armature rectifiers are released, so as to set the firing angle at the highest value. So now what it will be happens, the current is forced to the zero, then afterwards what will be happens, the firing angle continuously to the brake and then accelerate the motor at constant current to the desired speed in reverse direction. So here I conclude that by changing the reversing of the supply of field to connected field is reversed, means the motor direction can be reversed. Okay, so let us, this is the last slide. Okay, anyhow, so far I have discussed about the multi quadrant operation. It's nothing but what? Multi quadrant operation with regenerative braking. So it means what? All four quadrant operation by possible three methods I have discussed. One is a single fully controlled rectifier with reversing switch by changing the supply voltage by using the reversing switch. Okay, thyristors are used, the contactor also I have discussed, contactor also used. So second one is dual converter. There also we have discussed about the circulating current and non-circulating current mode, how it will be operates the four quadrant, and finally the field current reversal I have discussed. Okay, so here I conclude. Okay, next session I will go through the numeric problem on dual converter. Okay, thank you, thank you. थैंक यू।